Greetings. The message of the prophets glorifies God, the God of the prophets. If you are interested to know what the prophets revealed, I encourage you to watch this whole video. The prophets were all sent by the God of Abraham, the God who revealed the Torah and Bible. Their message is what God wanted humanity to know about Him. There is a city which God calls His holy city. Isaiah 48:2, for they call themselves of the holy city, and stay themselves upon the God of Israel. Yahweh of hosts is His name. Isaiah 60 verse 14, the sons also of them that afflicted thee shall come bending unto thee, and all they that despise thee shall bow themselves down at the soles of thy feet, and they shall call thee the city of the Lord, the Zion of the Holy One of Israel. There is a holy city, the city of the Lord, Yahweh. Daniel 9:16, O Lord, according to all thy righteousness I beseech thee, let thine anger and thine fury be turned away from thy city Jerusalem, thy holy mountain, because of our sins and for the iniquities of our fathers. Jerusalem and thy people are become a reproach to all that are about us. Ever wonder why Jerusalem is the center of the world's focus? Why are Jerusalem and the Jewish people the hated of all about them? Daniel 9:24. 70 weeks are determined upon thy people and upon thy holy city. We know this is Jerusalem. To finish the transgression and to make an end of sins and to make reconciliation for iniquity and to bring in everlasting righteousness and to seal up the vision and prophecy and to anoint the most holy. It is so significant Jerusalem is mentioned in prophecy. Those are just some of the references that specifically call out Jerusalem as God's holy city. But Jerusalem, the name of God's holy city, is mentioned 767 times in the King James Bible. The prophets mention Jerusalem so much because it is the capital of the nation of Israel. The capital of the nation God promised as an eternal covenant with Isaac. Genesis 17:8, I will give to you and to your descendants after you the land of your sojournings, all the land of Canaan for an everlasting possession, and I will be their God. 2 Samuel 15:8, for thy servant vowed a vow while I abode at Geshur in Syria, saying, if the Lord shall bring me again indeed to Jerusalem, then I will serve the Lord. That is interesting, placing a condition on God. If God will bring him again to Jerusalem, then he will serve God, only if he gets to go back to Jerusalem. If the Lord shall bring me again indeed to Jerusalem, then I will serve the Lord. 1 Kings 2:11, and the days that David reigned over Israel were 40 years. 7 years reigned he in Hebron, or Hebron, and 33 years reigned he in Jerusalem. Jerusalem, the holy city, is also called the city of David. The message of the prophets constantly references Jerusalem. 1 Kings 8:1, then Solomon assembled the leaders of Israel and all the heads of the tribes, the chief of the fathers of the children of Israel, unto King Solomon in Jerusalem, that they might bring up the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord out of the city of David, which is Zion. King Solomon, the prophet, ruled in Jerusalem. Jerusalem is mentioned 767 times in the King James Bible. It is also mentioned as thy holy city without using the name Jerusalem. I did not count those. But the word Jerusalem does not happen even one time in the Quran of Muhammad. Not one single time. Islam has no right to Jerusalem. 1 Kings 11:42, and the time that Solomon reigned in Jerusalem over all Israel was 40 years. Ever hear the expression Jumpin' Jehoshaphat? He had a son named Jehoram. 2 Kings 8:17. 32 years old was he when he began to reign, and he reigned 8 years in Jerusalem. He was not a good king. He did evil in the sight of God. But he still reigned in Jerusalem. Ezra 7:15. And to carry the silver and gold which the king and his counselors have freely offered unto the God of Israel, whose habitation is in Jerusalem. The God of Israel, whose habitation is in Jerusalem. Ezra 7:16. And all the silver and gold that thou canst find in all the province of Babylon, with the freewill offering of the people and of the priests, offering willingly for the house of their God, which is in Jerusalem. Ezra 7:27. Blessed be Yahweh, God of our fathers, which has put such a thing as this in the king's heart, to beautify the house of Yahweh, which is in Jerusalem. Ezra 8:29. Watch ye and keep them until you weigh them before the chief of the priests and the Levites, and the chief of the fathers of Israel, at Jerusalem, in the chambers of the house of Yahweh. Psalm 116:19. In the courts of Yahweh's house, in the midst of you, O Jerusalem, praise the Lord. Psalm 122:6. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. They shall prosper that love thee. Psalm 125:2. As the mountains are round about Jerusalem, so the Lord is round about his people from henceforth even forever. Psalm 128:5. The Lord shall bless thee out of Zion, and thou shalt see the good of Jerusalem all the days of thy life. Psalm 147:12. Praise the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise thy God, O Zion. Song of Solomon 5:16. His mouth is most sweet, yea, he is altogether lovely. This is my beloved, and this is my friend, O daughters of Jerusalem. Isaiah 2:1. The word that Isaiah the son of Amoz saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. Jerusalem is mentioned 767 times. This is the message of the prophets. Jerusalem is the holy city of Yahweh, God. Do you wonder why the world that hates God is jealous for his city? Luke 13:34. O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, which killest the prophets and stonest them that are sent unto thee, how often I would have gathered thy children together as a hen does gather her brood under her wings, and you would not. John 5:1. After this there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. The Messiah enjoyed the feasts of Yahweh in Jerusalem. Luke 24:49. And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. This is talking of the Comforter. But tarry you in the city of Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. The promised Comforter of John 14:15 and 16 was sent to them in Jerusalem. If you respect the message of the prophets and the God who sent them, you need to understand and recognize that Jerusalem is the capital of Israel forever. Isaiah 52:1. Awake, awake, clothe yourself in your strength, O Zion. Clothe yourself in your beautiful garments, O Jerusalem, the holy city, for the uncircumcised and the unclean will no longer come into you. Even after the coming cataclysm of end-time events, it will not be the end of Jerusalem. Revelation 21:2. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. So if you say you respect the prophets, you need to respect Israel's right to Jerusalem. the holy city of God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.